So to start off, I am going to be using a Kreolan TV paint stick in the shade white to get an opaque white base for this makeup. If you are recreating this makeup look, I would recommend that you cover all exposed skin, including neck, chest, and even ears.
So now that I have applied my Kreolan TV paint stick in white all over my face and exposed skin, I am going to set it using a white eyeshadow. The eyeshadow that I will be using today is from e.l.f. This is just a white eyeshadow in the corner here, but any white shadow will do. So now I have powdered my face with the white eyeshadow. I am going to contour with a pink. And I'm gonna go in with this pink shade right here. To contour my neck, I'm going to take that same shade, just ever so lightly. So now that we have a good base of a contour shade, I'm going to go in with a highlight. These are eyeshadows from Essence. I'm just gonna go in with this light pink shade. I do have a giveaway going on with Essence, so be sure to check the description bar if you are interested in entering for a giveaway. It's super easy. I do still want to maintain that white, so I'm not applying this in the highest points of my cheeks or my face. I still want to keep a hint. For a pop of color, I'm going to go into this bright pink shade. I'm going to take that same pink shade from Makeup Forever and apply it to my crease. Also going to take that same pink shade and go underneath the eye. To get a more concentrated pink, I'm going to go into certain areas to just get more pigmentation out of the same eyeshadow. So going in with an even deeper color, I'm going to take this Femme Rosa palette from ColourPop. This is the She palette, and I'm going to take that red right there. I do believe I have a review of this palette up on my channel. I don't think it's available anymore, but any burgundy eyeshadow will do. Also, if you ever want to test out how good an eyeshadow really is, one of these looks is really great because it will show you the true blendability of your shadow and pigmentation. Take a little bit of that same color underneath the eye. And a little bit to deepen up the crease. Whatever's left on the brush, I'm just gonna contour my nose ever so slightly. Don't want anything crazy. Just a little definition. Now that I look like I have Angelina Jolie's cheekbones, let's move on. So for the lid space of my eyes, I'm going to be using the I Love You So Mochi NYX palette, and I'm going to be using this light pink shade right here. These eyeshadows, I feel like you really need to use your finger with, because every single time I try and use a brush, they don't really work too well. That's pretty. Take a little bit of that same shade on the tip of the nose. Just a little pink. And whatever's left on your Cupid's bow. For lip liner today, let's keep on going with the pink theme. And we're gonna be using a NYX Slide On, Glide On, Stay On, and definitely a Turn On Waterproof Extreme Color Lip Liner. That name. This lip liner is so good the name had to be this long. Really? Okay. The shade is Disco Rage. So since this is a love potion Halloween tutorial, I don't want to be typical and do a heart on the lips, but I do want to do little lips. This lip liner is okay. It's a bit drying, so not my favorite, but it's the perfect color for this look. Going in with MAC Brick Lip Pencil to give a ombre effect. Going to use a Wet n Wild liquid catsuit in the shade Oh My Dolly. Whew, that color. So I know it's slightly hard to see, but my lip line, my natural lip line, goes all the way out here. So I shortened them and I kind of plumped them up. Since I am using this compact, it's just like a compact. I know it's an eyeshadow palette, but I'm going to take this pink here, right here, just with my finger. Pop it on the inner corner. It's from Lancome. The shade is Click. And then to darken up my hairline just a little bit and blend it in, I'm going to take in this black from the Naked 2 palette, Blackout. Just ever so slightly. This black is super pigmented, so just use a little bit to deepen up your contour. So, sticking with the pink theme again, going in with my Pacifica Rose Flower Hydro Mist. So I'm going to line my eyes with a black liner. This one is from Pixie. And then I'm going to glue on some lashes. These are just generic lashes that I picked up from the store. Because this is a love potion, I thought maybe I would try a little bit lighter lashes. So next I'm just gonna apply my trusty mascara. This is from Essence, the Lashes of the Day Super Volume Mascara. For eyebrows, I'm gonna take this cake eyeliner from Ben Nye. And I'm gonna use a wet angled brush. I know I'm not normally one for crazy brows, but I really like them in Halloween makeups. And if you wanna do a little bit of a liner just to hide the lash band, you can do that too. Okay, so now we are moving to the crazy fun bit, which is slightly terrifying because you can't really control too much of it, but face paint time and drip time. So I'm gonna use one of my Mayron palettes. This is their Paradise Makeup. Let's do this one in pastel. Boom, these two pinks, yes. And they smell great. They smell like coconut or like tropical. And then we're also going to use this little pink guy right here, which is a Wolf Face Art. Same thing, different company. Okay, so I want to start with this guy. So I'm going to get a little brush, this one, which is normally like a lip brush. So I got some water in my little cup and I added it to this little pink shade right here, just swirling it to mix the color and get the pigment into the water. And then we are going to go for it. I'm also going to do some drips coming down from here. So doing the same thing with the Mayron face paints. Okay, so I'm just gonna go in with this last shade right here, this medium pink. Just kidding, it's the lightest. Thought it was gonna be medium. It's okay. So, just to finish off the look, I'm going to curl my hair and make it look a little more romantic, and I will be right back. Hi, this is Spilt Love Potion, and I am here to spill the tea. Not literally. I don't want to ruin my new sweater. But the reason I was spilt was Diane was getting a warm cup of milk and she tripped in the kitchen and she spilled her milk everywhere. Just dairy everywhere. If you were lactose intolerant, you'd scream. So then Sam comes running in because she hears Diane crying. And Sam says, "Don't worry. Don't cry over spilt milk." She takes one step in the kitchen, slips, falls, spills me all over the place. Then she starts crying. But Diane couldn't say, "Don't cry over spilt love potion," because that isn't a saying, is it? Now Josh is riding off into the sunset with Laurel, because she didn't have a friend like Diane, spilling milk in the kitchen, ruining potential love stories. Don't get a friend like Diane, and do cry over spilt milk. Hope you enjoyed the tea. See you guys next time.